DNS is a distributed directory. Around the world, there are several root servers, which direct requests to top-level domain servers, like for.com, which in turn direct requests to the servers for particular domains. This means that no one DNS server needs to know all the records for all the names and domains in the world. The records for a particular domain, like an A record for www.greenspaceghost.com, will be found in the authoritative name servers for that domain, like the name server for greenspaceghost.com, which are listed in NS records for the higher level zone. So the NS record for greenspaceghost.com will reside in the name servers for com, or .com, either way. Com, org, and edu, and net, and a few others are global top-level domains, or GTLDs, and their NS records are stored in the root servers. To make it faster and more complicated, the DNS server that the client, or resolver, talks to isn't some sort of global master server. Resolvers normally talk to a nearby caching DNS server. For a home user, that might be the local home router, or it might be run by their ISP, or it could be a well-known DNS service like Google Public DNS. When that caching server receives a query from a client, first it consults its local cache. If the cache doesn't know what the record is, the caching server recursively resolves the query, forwarding to the appropriate name servers, possibly first at the root, and then at the top-level domain, and then at the lower-level domain, until eventually it gets back an answer. Then it stores that result in its cache, so it doesn't have to run the same query over and over again every time you look up udacity.com or google.com or whatever. And finally, it's able to return that result to the client. But caching can cause problems. If you want to move your site from one IP address to another, like if you're moving your website from Google to Amazon, and some DNS cache has the old address, then clients who use that cache will see the old address instead of the new one. To cut down on this kind of thing, DNS records have a time to live, or TTL, which tells caches how long to cache them for. For instance, these records that I just used dig to get for udacity.com have a time to live of 60 seconds. If I look them up from the cache later, the time to live is reduced. Now it's down to 22 seconds, and 14, and after the TTL expires, caching servers have to go back to the authoritative server again, look the record up to make sure that their information is fresh.